common with the nucleus tractus solitaris sensory, and its own nucleus, nucleus dorsalis nervi. You see that it is the largest parasympathetic nerve of the rhomboid form. It means it innervates more structures than other nerves. Yes, it innervates all structures of the neck, thorax, and abdominal cavity. All structures which has glands and smooth muscles. All internal organs. It is the main parasympathetic nerve of the body. So it starts from the same place of the brain, less below nervous, below sopharyngeus, this one, you see? From the same groove in the back of oliva. Goes through foramen regulare and consists of four parts. First part, pars cranialis, inside the cavity of the skull. Pars cervicalis, on the level of the cervix. Pars thoracica, in the thoracic cavity, and pars abdominalis and abdominal cavity. Pars cervicalis gives only two nerves, both are sensory. Ramus meningeus, which innervate meninges of posterior cranial fossa, and ramus auricularis, which goes to posterior side of auricula and external meatus. So, next, pars thoracica. In this place, it gives motor and sensory branches to the pharynx. You know plexus pharyngeus and the nervous hypoglossus. Glossopharyngeus takes part in it, but glossopharyngeus gives...
What happened?
So, muscles of the pharynx. Then, three branches which go to the heart. Ramus...
Stop talking!
Ramus cardiacus cervicalis superior, ramus cardiacus cervicalis medius, and ramus cardiacus cervicalis inferior. Next, nervus laryngeus superior, laryngeal nerve, which gives internal and external branches. Internal branch penetrates the membrane and innervates everything above the vocal cords. External branch goes to musculus cricothyroideus. So, and the lowest nerve is nervus laryngeus recurrens, nerves which comes back to the larynx. But what difference between right and left nervus laryngeus recurrens? The right lung surrounds the subclavian artery, the right side, and comes back. The left one surrounds the aorta. That's why the cervical part of the left vagus nerve is longer than the right one. Because the lower border of the cervical part is the place of nervus laryngeus recurrens origin. So, nervus laryngeus recurrens elevates between trachea and esophagus and supply them, you see, supplying each of them, and elevates to the larynx. Inside the larynx, it innervates all other muscles. So, next, thoracic part. In thoracic part, nervus vagus goes by the difficult way at the right and left side. The left nervus vagus goes in front of esophagus. The right one goes in the back of esophagus and forms together plexus esophagus. See? The left one, right in the back. So, together they innervate the esophagus. Additionally, give branches to lungs. Rami pulmonalis, to bronchi, rami bronchialis, to trachea, rami trachealis, to the pleura, rami pleuralis, to the pericardium, rami pericardiati. So, all surrounded organs receive a lot of fibers from the nervus vagus, anterior and posterior trunks. Why the left one goes in the front? Because at the intrauterine development, the stomach change its position. First, it locates in sagittal plane. Then it rotates to the right. And you see, after this rotation, my left hand appeared in front. The stomach rotates, the esophagus rotates, and both nervus vagus rotates. That's why nervus vagus sinister in front, nervus vagus dexter in back. Then Both goes to abdominal cavity through hiatus esophagus and continues with the pars abdominalis. In this place, they change its name. We have truncus vagalis anterior, continuation of the left vagus nerve, and truncus vagalis posterior, continuation of the right one. And the right one, mainly, and left one, connected with plexus celiacus, another name, plexus solaris. What is it? It is sympathetic plexus around the upper vessel of abdominal cavity. Truncus celiacus, which supplies all organs of superior level of the peritoneal cavity. It supplies the liver, the stomach, the pancreas, the spleen, and so on. So, surrounded with sympathetic nerves, and they receive also parasympathetic fibers from nervous vagus. You can see that from this place, all vessels surrounded with the nerves. You see? That nerves as sympathetic as parasympathetic. And now you know that all organs which receive the blood from the vessels additionally receive nerves which surround the vessels. The stomach, you see? It receives vessels surrounded with sympathetic and parasympathetic fibers. Parasympathetic are continuation of nervous vagus. Then this liver, same, you see, hepatic artery keeps the plexus, sympathicus and parasympathicus. Then renal artery, you see, the kidney receives sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve, continuation of plexus solaris for continuation of nervous vagus. You see. Ureter, same. Suprarenal glands, same. Then intestine, same. You see. Duodenal artery gives as blood as nerves around. Then, you see. This, the small intestine receives nerves. Understand? So, most organs locate above the level of sigmoid colon, receives same innervation from nervous vagus. You see? And that fibrous get organs surrounded corresponding vessels. You will learn that vessels next year. Now you have only remember that all vessels which supply abdominal cavity give continuation of vagus nerve for parasympathetic innervation. Another nerve for the next classes is nervous accessorius. Nervous accessorius has two types of nucleus. Cranial part is a certain portion of nucleus ambiguus and mainly spinal part. This place. And this nerve starts from the spinal nerve mainly, with the several roots. That roots goes between anterior and posterior roots of cranial of spinal nerves, you see? Then it elevates to the cavity of the skull through foramen magnum and leaves it through foramen regulare, together with nervus vagus and glossopharyngeus. Then nervous accessorius goes out and innervates two main muscles, nervous musculus sternocleidomastoideus and musculus trapezius. The two muscles have the same development, that's why they receive the same innervation and surrounded with the same fascia. So it will be for the next class. Nervous vagus, nervous glossopharyngeus, nervous accessorius, and all other nerves like glossopharyngeus, hypoglossus, facialis, and trigeminus. To the concluding session the day after tomorrow, second period. So, human talk to anatomy class.